Hello and welcome everyone. In today's video, we see the game between Fabiano Caruana with white and Erik Hansen with black. I found this game very exciting, so I tried to analyze in great detail. Hope you like it. So let's start. Caruana starts with the move e4. Black played e5, knight f3, knight to c6, bishop b5, a6 attacking the bishop, bishop a4. Knight to f6, castle, bishop to e7, rook to e1 protecting the e4 pawn, b5 attacking the bishop, bishop b3. This opening setup is known as closed variation of the Royal Lopez. Now black played d6, a4 with the idea of attacking b5 with the threat of rook cross a8. Now bishop d7 heading support to the rook, c3 opening a vacant square for the bishop, castle, d4, h6, preventing bishop g5 and knight g5 ideas, knight b to d2, black played rook e8, now knight f1, black played bishop f4, attacking the e4 pawn indirectly, now knight g3, defending the e4 pawn, knight a5, attacking the b3 bishop, bishop c2, and now here black played c5, h3 covering the g4 square, queen to c7, d5 closing the center, and here black played c4, knight h4 with the idea of knight f5, g6 preventing knight f5, bishop e3, and here black played knight b7. Knight b7 is a mistake. Instead of knight b7, rook e to b8 is a good move with the idea of playing b4, opening up the b file and trying to generate attack on white's queen side since the center is closed. But he played knight to b7. White played queen to d2, attacking the h6 pawn, king h7, protecting the h6 pawn. Now rook f1. According to the engines, instead of rook f1, the move f4 directly is more accurate, but who knows, Caruana had some different ideas, so he played the move rook f1. Black played queen d8 with the idea of knight cross e4 and taking the knight on h4. White played a cross b5. Here you cannot play the move knight cross e4, as after knight cross e4, knight cross e4, queen cross h4, white will play b cross a6, and white have a very dangerous passed pawn, so it is not good for black. That's why black played a cross b5, and now white played rook takes a8, queen takes a8, and now f4. Since black have to attack on queen side and white have to attack on king side, that's why he played f4. Now black played bishop g7, white played f5, g5, knight to f3, and knight c5. Knight c5 is not a very accurate move because it allows the move bishop cross c5, and hence black have doubled pawn and white have protected passed pawn, which is very dangerous in the end games. Instead of knight cross c5, the best move is to play queen a2, trying to attack the weakness of b2 pawn and also trying to play on the queen side. But he played knight to c5, white played knight h2, he missed the idea of bishop cross c5. The idea of playing knight h2 is, since the knight is not doing very much on f3, that's why Caruana want to exchange it via g4 square. Black played bishop c8, is a serious mistake. Instead of bishop c8, the best move is to play rook c8 because it avoids the doubling of pawns. But he played bishop c8. Now white returned the mistake favor. He played queen e2. Again he missed the move bishop cross c5, which is the best move. After d cross c5, bishop d1, bishop d7, knight to g4, trying to exchange the knight, queen a6, knight takes f6, bishop takes f6, knight h5 attacking the bishop, queen d6, queen f2 with some tactical possibility of knight cross f6, queen cross f6, and c5 pawn is overloaded. So rook c8, bishop g4 and bishop e8. We can see white pieces are very active here, and on the contrary, black's pieces are very passive and also defending. So white is very very much better here. But white missed the move and played the move queen e2. Black immediately replied with the move knight c to d7. He realized the mistake and retreated the knight. White played b3. B3 is a blunder. The idea is to attack c4 and b5 pawn. But white missed the move bishop a6 of his opponent. Let me show you the variation. Instead of bishop b3, the best move is to play rook b1, queen a2, queen d1 with the idea of queen c1, defending b2 and playing rook a1. But he played bishop b7 with the idea of rook a8, so you cannot play rook a1. Now here white stabilizes the attack on the queen side, so he is ready to attack on the king side with the move knight to g4, which is a very stable position for white. But instead white played b3. Now black played c cross b3, bishop cross b3, and black played queen a5. Here black also missed the move, missed the idea of the move bishop a6. Instead of queen a5, the best response is to play queen a3. Queen a3 not only protects b5 pawn but also the b2 square from the queen, as after queen cross b5, the idea is to play bishop a6. This is the idea white and black both are totally missed. So that's why instead of queen cross b5, white have to play queen b1. And then after bishop a6, here the position is playable for black. Black's pieces are very much active and white did not have time to attack on black king. So that's why here queen a3 is very bad. Queen a3 is a better move. But instead black played queen a5, attacking the c3 pawn. White instantly played queen b2 with the idea of move rook to a1. Now black played knight c5, attacking the bishop and the pawn. Rook a1, attacking the queen. Queen c7, and now bishop c2, protecting e4 and also attacking the b5 pawn. Bishop d7, saving the b5 pawn. Queen b4, rook to c8, attacking the c3 pawn indirectly. Here white played c4. C4 is a very good move in practical, as white have a weak and backward c3 pawn, which he exchanged with the well protected black's b5 pawn. Black played bishop cross b cross c4, queen takes c4, and now rook b8. Here white played knight to g4, trying to exchange the defender of the black king. Knight takes g4, h takes g4, and black played here bishop to f6. It is a big blunder by black, which leads to an instant tactical combination for white. Instead of bishop f6, the best move is to play king g8. But after bishop f6, white played the move knight h5, attacking the bishop. Here white returns the favor and missed the tactical combination completely. Did you spot it? You can pause the video and try to find the best move. Okay, so if you've done it, let's see. The best move here is to play bishop cross c5. Now black have two main moves, d cross c5 and queen cross c5. Both are losing. First see the move queen cross c5. After queen cross c5, queen takes c5, d takes c5, and now rook to a7, attacking both the bishop and the f7 pawn. Now black have two ways. First bishop e8 and the second is rook d8. First we see the move rook d8. Now knight to h5, attacking the bishop, bishop h8, and then king f2. Here we can see the black pieces are tied up and very passive, so white is very much better here. And in the previous we already seen the move rook d8, so the other variation is bishop to e8. After bishop to e8, white will play knight h5, attacking the bishop, bishop d8, and now d6 with the idea of playing d7 and trapping the bishop. So bishop b5, and now rook cross f7. Here white has overwhelming advantage. So let's see the second variation. So we have already seen the variation of queen cross c5. Now if black plays d takes c5, d6, attacking the queen and also the f7 pawn. Now queen takes f7 check, king h8 and knight h5. Here the bishop is attacked twice and white also threatens checkmate on the g7 square, so it is completely winning for white. So that's why a bishop cross c5 is the best move which Caruana missed. Instead he played the move knight to h5. Black played here bishop to e7. Again now black is completely losing. He again did a blunder and allowed another tactical combination. Sorry, the same tactical combination. And in this time white spotted and played bishop cross c5. Now rook to c8 he played. Instead of rook c8, black has some other options which are losing, like if you play bishop c8 here, now rook a7 loses for black. Instead of bishop c8, we can try another queen cross c5 move. After queen cross c5, d takes c5, rook a7, as we seen earlier, rook d8, d6, bishop takes d6, and now knight f6 check. Here white wins the piece here, so it is also winning for white. Now okay, now instead of rook c8 we see the third move, d cross c5, sorry, d cross c5, and now here d6 also loses. But black played here rook to c8. After rook c8, white replied with the move rook to a6. Black played king g8. The other moves are also losing here, like if black played d takes c5, d6, with the same idea white is winning here. Instead if black will play queen cross c5, then queen cross c5, d takes c5, rook to a7 attacking the bishop, rook d8, d6, bishop takes, and again the knight f6 check wins the piece. So all other moves are also winning, but black played king to g8, white played bishop to b3, queen b7 attacking the rook, attacking the bishop, all is losing for black. Now white played rook to a7, queen a7, bishop to a7, and it was in this position that black resigns here, because after the move rook takes c4, bishop takes c4, white is piece up here and completely winning. Okay, so that's all for this. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you.